It has been reported recently that the Election Commission of India has told the government that it is technically and administratively ready to offer what it calls electronically transmitted postal ballot system, ETPBS, to enable NRIs to vote from wherever they are in the world. And it has said that, it will be ready to do this for the Assam, Bengal, Tamil Nadu and Puducherry elections due next year. Now, this in and of itself would be a very good idea if it did not have other implications. The implications are the following. The NRIs, estimated number of NRIs across the world is about 1 crore, out of which about 60 lakhs might be eligible for voting. So, for these 60 lakh voters, the Election Commission seems to be going through a lot of effort because this effort of trying to get NRIs to vote began in 2010. First, the Representation of People Act and the Registration of Electoral Rules were amended. Then PILs were filed in the Supreme Court in 2010, 2013, 2014. As a result of those PILs, the Election Commission set up a committee to look into this possibility, and which committee recommended e-postal ballot and proxy voting. And accordingly, the Election Commission wrote to the Government of India in 2015. The government prepared a draft bill to amend the Representation of People Act in 2017. That bill was passed by the Lok Sabha, but before it could be passed in the Rajya Sabha, the Lok Sabha was dissolved and the bill lapsed. So that is where the matter stood. Till now, on December 1, 2020, we got this news that there is Election Commission is now ready. why this is a little contentious is... as I said, there are about 1 crore NRIs with 60 lakh being eligible for voting. On the other side, we have what I would like to call MRIs, migrant resident Indians. So there are, earlier most people didn't know about these migrants, but I thought after the lockdown, which began on 24th of March this year, when we saw thousands and thousands of migrants walking back to their villages hundreds of miles away, it seemed that the nation has recognized that there are a large number of migrants. Now, if you look at that number, the 2011 census estimated the number of migrants to be 45.4 crores. 45.4 crores, out of which 28.5 crore would be eligible to vote. Now, this 28.5 crore eligible to vote would be about 38% of the total registered voters in the country. Now, these 38% don't really have any practical means for voting. The Election Commission's suggestion has been that they can register themselves wherever they are and vote there. Now, since they are migrant workers, they don't stay in one place, for 3 years or 5 years, so that they register. The second problem is that the registration process is not really very amenable for use by migrant laborers. A lot of them are sort of hardly literate. Three, getting oneself registered as a voter, regardless of what has been said, takes a few days, 2, 3, 4 days. And for those days, this migrant worker will have to forego her or his wages. So getting it registered at the place of where they are working is not really practical. The other option is for them to travel to their villages, etc., to vote. which again means a loss of 3-4 days of wages, expenditure on travel, etc., which these people cannot afford. So therefore, the request to Election Commission has been for quite some time that they should first make arrangements so that the migrant resident Indians, MRIs, can conveniently take part in the election process in the country where they live, rather than giving preference to some, 60 lakh NRIs who have chosen to leave the country of their own accord. And they are living outside the country not for any other reason except that they have chosen to do so. Now, and since they live out of the country, their concern for the political governance of the country obviously cannot be that of the, 28.5 crores migrant workers who are in the country, who are really working hard. The reason for this seems not very difficult to guess. The NRIs are rich, they have money, they are organized, and they have influence. The MRIs, or the migrant resident workers, are diffused. They are not organized into a voting bloc. They are poor. They really have no say. This is like, the saying that the squeaky wheel gets the grease, which is rather unfair. It seems reasonable that we should first make arrangements for the migrant resident Indians who are in India and much larger in number, rather than trying to get well-heeled NRIs to be able to vote so that they can influence the political situation in the country when they are not even physically here. I think the Election Commission needs a rethink. And of course, the latest news that came around is that the government has said that this needs more consultation, and that it has so far been dealt with only at the bureaucratic level. It still needs to be discussed at the political level. So one hopes better sense will prevail, and migrants who are in the country, they will be given the first priority on making it possible for them to vote, rather than trying to, for want of a better word, pander to a few well-heeled people who have chosen to leave the country, chosen to stay away. They should not be given this kind of a right before the poor folks who are working in India, who are actually building the infrastructure of India. Further to what I just said in the preceding video, here is an update on the arrangements for enabling NRIs to vote from where they are in the world. After the reports of December 1 and December 15 that I mentioned in the earlier video, on December 21, a report was published in a leading newspaper which said, and I quote, that the Election Commission is examining a plan to allow migrants to vote for a candidate in their home constituencies from anywhere in the country, end of quote. This is a very encouraging development. And the report further says that the, quote again, the full Election Commission is set to soon deliberate a conceptual framework of the technology to enable vote from anywhere with the 2024 Lok Sabha elections in mind. Pilot runs are likely to be done during bi-polls, end of quote. Now, this is very nice to hear that the Election Commission is working on enabling migrants, or MRIs, as I said in the earlier video, enable them to vote from wherever they are in the country. But the only minor concern is that the conceptual framework of the technology is still to be discussed. Now, this means that there is quite some time, but then I suppose 2024 elections for the Lok Sabha are also quite some time away. One hopes that by then the arrangement for allowing migrant workers within India to vote from wherever they are in their own constituencies can be finalized. That would be very nice.